Good morning, Maria Regina. Thank you for joining us on a chilly Friday morning.
We have a jam-packed broadcast, so let's get started.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, is not this the fast that I choose, to loose the bonds of injustice? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry, and bring the homeless poor into your house, when you see the naked to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin? Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your healing shall spring up quickly. Your vindictator shall go before you. The glory of the Lord shall be your rear guard. If you remove the yoke from among you, the pointing of the finger, the speaking of the evil, if you offer your food to the hungry and satisfy the needs of the afflicted, then your light shall rise in the darkness, and your gloom be like the noonday. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Maria Regina, pray for us. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Now our kindergarten friends will lead us in the pledge.
They join in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Addison and Alan. Hey, John, what's with the huge smile?
Nothing. I just love when our kindergartner friends lead us in the pledge to think we are that little and adorable ones.
They are cute, and they're doing a great job. Keep up the good work, little friends. You may be seated. We'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Dominic Regina, along with the faculty and staff celebrating birthdays this month. Ms. Pistocchi, Ms. Cox, Ms. Pistorino, Ms. Zaro, Mrs. Randazzo, and Mrs. Halpin.
I'm glad it's your birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, Julia, I can't wait any longer. You know the next segment is my favorite.
Alrighty then, let's get right to it. Let's go to Sophia in the Together We Shine studio to see who is in this week's spotlight. Sophia?
Thank you, John and Julia. With so much going on, we had another difficult choice to make. However, the decision has been made. So dim the lights and envelope, please. This week, we'd like to shine a spotlight on the students who donated to the American Heart Association and participated in the Kids Heart Challenge. Let's go to Jake for more. Jake?
Thank you, Sophia. This past week, students in kindergarten through grade 8 participated in the Kids Heart Challenge. This event wrapped up our fundraising for the American Heart Association. Did you know that heart disease remains the number one cause of death among men and women worldwide and strokes the rank the second globally? Over the past 100 years, the American Heart Association has invested $4.1 billion for research. They've helped to fund medical breakthroughs in reducing high blood pressure, stents, correcting heart defects in newborns, pacemakers, and much more. But that's not enough. Heart disease is still the leading cause of death, and their mission is to stop this statistic. Through the fantastic efforts of our schools, students, families, and friends, we're able to raise over $3,000 to support heart health and research to find a cure for all types of heart disease. Thank you to all who participated and raised money. However, there was one student who raised over $1,300. And lucky me, I'm staying right next to him. Ashton Wilkins is in Mrs. Scarino's class, in Mrs. Scarino's kindergarten class. Hello, Ashton. Let me be the first one to congratulate you. Ashton, so how do you feel about raising the most money out everyone in our school?
I feel so good. I feel so happy about that.
You raised $1,300 for a great cause. That's a lot of money. What do you think you could do with $1,300?
Buy Mom a car.
Well, congratulations, Ashton. Well done. Back to you, Sophia, in the Together We Shine studio.
Wow. Let's give another round of applause for Ashton. Kudos to Maria Regina for raising over $3,000. With the staggering statistic as the one Jake mentioned, I'm sure we all know someone who is dealing with a heart condition. Let's remember to keep them in our prayers, and let's be the generation that is aware of heart health. I know we are married to our devices, but there are harmful effects. We are kids, so why don't we make a pact to limit our screen time and get up and move? We do not want to be a statistic. Back to John and Julia in the Faith Forward studio.
Thank you, Sophia. What are you doing, John?
Exercising, Julia, exercising. I want to stay healthy.
Oh, Johnny boy, you're really something else. Hey, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
I mean, can you stop exercising for a minute?
Sure, what is it?
Did you happen to attend the science fair last week?
Did I? No, not only did I attended. I was able to chat with a few peers and saw some really cool projects. Why don't we take a look at some footage from the science fair?
Hello, I'm John Bono, right here at the Marie Regina's Science Fair. I'm here with Brianna. Brianna, can you tell me something good about your project?
Yeah. So for my project, I wanted to test the diverse solubility of anti-inflammatory drugs, including methotrexate, diclofenac, nabutin, and ibuprofen. I wanted to test how fast they can dissolve in salt water, water, and vinegar. My hypothesis was that ibuprofen would dissolve the fastest because when we take it, we want instant relief pain. My hypothesis was proven correct, and I've learned so much about medicines and the world of science.
Hello, I'm here with Julia. Julia, tell us something interesting about your project.
So for my science fair project, I did spherification. So my problem was, what is the effect of different pHs on the ability of liquids to undergo spherification, and does the addition of sodium citrate change the pH of liquids affecting the spherification process? So my hypothesis was that if I add the chemical sodium citrate to certain liquids, it will then alter the liquid's pH and affect its ability to undergo spherification. I believe that the more acidic a liquid is, the more difficult it will be for a sphere to form. So in the end, the green tea, I used green tea, orange juice, lemon juice, and Coca-Cola. And in the end, the green tea worked the most efficiently because it's a basic, so it's not very acidic, so it was able to form spheres the best.
That sounds amazing. Thank you, Julie. Hello, I'm here with Mariana. Mariana, can you tell me some things about your project?
Okay, so I tested what sunscreen works the best. These sunscreens are the tested, and I put them under a UV light to see which one's going to work the best.
That was amazing. Thank you.
Wow, great job. I learned so much from my peers. John, what are you doing now?
Please, call me Albert.
Albert?
Yes, as in Albert Einstein. I was so inspired by the project at the science fair that I've been concluding my own experiments ever since I think one day I'll like to be a chemist.
A chemist?
Yes, a person who researches and involved in chemical experiments.
I'm getting scared. What are you doing? Or shall I say mixing?
I am making elephant toothpaste. Watch how its foamy substance is made by rapid decomposition of hydrogen peroxide and using potassium iodine as a reagent. Julia, you may want to step back for this. That stinks! Well, thanks for another Friday broadcast.
Thanks, John. While you clean up, how about we find out...
Where in the world is Miss Bestoki going today?
Hi, everyone. I'm back on the road again. Let's see if you can guess where I am. Ready? Okay. Clue number one. I hopped on an airplane and traveled across the Atlantic Ocean to Rome, Italy, before arriving at what is known as the smallest country in the world. It is so small that it's actually just over 100 acres, making it only the eighth of the size of Central Park. Clue number two. The leader of this country is in fact an absolute monarch with many different titles. one of which is the successor of the Prince of Apostles, which references the namesake for the building behind me and the square where I am standing. Clue number three, the leader of the church, Pope Francis, lives here. Do you know what country I'm in? That's right, I visited Vatican City. The Vatican has a rich, long history. It has been made the home to every pope dating back to the 14th century. Prior to that, the pope lived in a residency in Rome or for a short period of time in Avignon, France. Over 5 million people take the long pilgrimage to the Vatican every year. That's some 20,000 people a day. This is especially true during the Lenten season in which just began this week. People came from all over with the hopes of visiting some famous sites, including the Sistine Chapel, to see the paintings of Michelangelo on the walls and ceiling. The Vatican is most known for St. Peter's Square, which houses St. Peter's Basilica. It is believed that the tomb of our first Pope, St. Peter, is under the footing of the altar within the Basilica. For such a small place, there is so much to learn and experience. You should definitely make sure to visit here one day. John and Julia, back to you. Ciao.
Thank you, Ms. Pistocchi. John, what are you doing now?
I'm adding something to my bucket list, Vatican City.
I agree. Well, John, as much as we can go on, I know our teachers cannot wait for us to close our show so they can get their show on the road.
I know. Time to learn. Well, Maria Regina, thank you so much for joining us.
Until next week, now that we have begun our Lenten journey, let's put down our devices and make time to talk to God, as well as throw kindness around like confetti.
Thank you and have a blessed week. Come on! Come on! You're supposed to explode!